everyone, it's me, Scott, your trusted HostGator website guy. In this episode of Hosted, we'll cover my 5 favorite SEO things you can do right now to help your site get noticed. And stick around for some tips from HostGator's SEO master, Alexis Krasinski. Are you feeling desperate to get noticed? Not me. I'm confident enough in myself to not need to wear an obnoxious shirt. Well, if you are looking to get your website noticed, here are 5 easy things you can do to improve your SEO. Number 1, perform keyword research. My favorite go-to advice on optimizing SEO is to amp up your text with keywords. But did you know that there are tons of tools out there to help with keyword research? SEMrush.com and Ahrefs.com are 2 great examples that can help you gain insight into what potential visitors are looking for. Or try Google's Keyword Planner. Just like your old school Trapper Keeper Day Planner, but digital and built into your Google Ads console, and really not at all a day planner. It's free to get started and will even help you build very targeted ad campaigns with easy budgeting tools. Pro tip, when you're starting out, short keywords are highly competitive. So instead, find long tail keywords and get specific. For instance, web hosting would be probably competitive against a super awesome web hosting service provider like, I don't know, HostGator. You probably want something more specific, like web hosting for guys who need to build a website to get noticed by girls, or something like that, just as an example.
Try it, it doesn't work.
Number 2, plan site architecture. If you're George Costanza, another way to get noticed is by claiming you're an architect named Art Vandelay. Faking you are an architect won't help with your website's SEO, but planning your site's architecture will. It is important for your site to have a logical structure that is easy to follow for your visitors, promoting longer page visits and a better user experience. If you're just starting out, your site will be pretty simple, but some rules of thumb remain the same. Most sites should have a pyramid-style architecture with your homepage at top and secondary pages, the pages your main menu will navigate to, directly below. And below that, any subcategories or individual pages. With proper site architecture, you will become the master of your domain. Yes, love a good Seinfeld joke, though not at all what they were referencing in the show. Side note, if you find this video helpful, smash that like button. If you have questions about any of this, go ahead and ask me in the comments. I'll respond to all of them. Number 3, think mobile first. Did you know that about half of all website visits come from people on their phones? In fact, you're probably watching this on your phone right now. Yeah, I know you. You're watching on your phone. With so much traffic coming from mobile, it's super important to make sure your visitor experience is good on both mobile and desktop. Make sure it's responsive, avoid using flash, and use large buttons that are easy to tap on for people with clumsy thumbs. Like me! Number 4, focus on page speed. Here to help speed this point along, please welcome HostGator's SEO guru, Alexis Krasinski. Hey Alexis, how you doing?
Hey Scott, doing well.
So, why is page speed so important for SEO?
So page speed has always been important for SEO, but in 2021, it's going to become an even more essential component of your SEO strategy. In 2021, Google is planning on incorporating what they're calling Core Web Vitals into their algorithm, meaning your site rankings will be impacted by your page speed. You can track your CWV scores and other page speed metrics in Google Search Console, as well as Page Speed Insights, both tools created by Google.
So you're saying page speed is important. What can we do about it? What are your top 3 page speed improvement recommendations?
So my top 3 would definitely be to remove any unused JavaScript and CSS, defer off-screen images so your images only load when someone scrolls to see them, and eliminate render blocking resources, which basically means to make sure your code files are in the right order and to minify any extra code.
Got it. So making your code nice and tidy will keep things fast and help your SEO.
Exactly.
Cool. Man, everyone needs an Alexis in their life.
Yes.
Thanks for stopping by, Alexis. Number 5, optimize on-page elements. Search engines are smart, but still not human. So 2 things they can't do well are find true love and index things like images and animation. So you should focus on optimizing indexable elements. This means doing things like writing customized meta tags, meta titles, and meta descriptions, making sure your videos and images have text descriptions and captions with keywords, and get rid of any flash animations. They're not indexable and they don't load on all the devices anyway.
Ugh.
So gross. What year is it? 2002?
I wonder if Ross and Rachel will get back together again.
Until search engines learn to index love, focus on the things they can. And there you go. 5 easy things you can do right now to improve your SEO. So go do it. Now.
What are you still doing here?
The video's over. Go home.
Put your phone down.
I'm going to go optimize your SEO. Go. I'm going to go do it. Bye. Woo. Mike, do you have any favorite Seinfeld moments?
Who told you to put the bomb on? I didn't tell you to put the bomb on. Yes. Put the bomb on.
It was classic. he spills the coffee on himself, Kramer.
Yeah,
really good.
Anything Kramer and the lawyer, I just die.
Really good,
die.
Yeah. What's the lawyer's name? Do you remember?
Oh, God. Jazz.
If you know, leave it in the comments.
There it is.
Also, are you the master of your domain? Too much
information. Not that there's anything wrong with that.